She walked out of the room, possessed a stunning looking beauty. I gazed her. I woke up out of dreams when she winced and grinned indulgently, assuming my open mouth. I shook my head and smiled back. "I don't want to spoil your dressing." She giggled, pulled my hand and said, "Don't be crazy now. It's getting late." She paused for a moment before opening the gate, stood still in front of me, constant lingering her glance at my other shoulders, mending collar, buttoning shirt, setting tie, and having a bland smile at her lips. I conjectured she desired to say something, so I looked straight into her eyes, assuring her tacitly. Our living together has given our people a reason to gossip. After a long time, you will be in the department before fellows, teachers, and acquaintances. It may be a little weird situation for you, but you have to be patient, said she convincingly. I can't imagine how embarrassing it has become for you. The comments and mocking you have to face these days, you carried all, you bore it. It held both her arms delicately, leaned my head onto her shoulders. When you are with me, I am unabased, and gossiping amongst people will die a natural death. We hugged. After the accident, it was my first day in the department. Urvasi had submitted my medical certificate to head of department though. As my name announced for poetry recital, the gathering hailed me with a thunderous round of applause. I strolled and rose to the dais. I prepared myself to read my emotional expression as the poetry out loud before the crowd. The clapping stopped. A deep quietness pondered everywhere in the echoing auditorium hall. After a brief greeting and introduction, I began my words, meeting with a stranger. You. Nobody I knew. When we met very first, sit at a bench under the verdurous tree of a random park, where tramps, rambles, laymen, old age and peers, we shared our sour, plain, sweet past. We talked, laughed and shared a gentle sensation when your touch relieved me being untouched. Her metamorphosis beauty in broad Bengali sari, glittering earrings, wistful Bengal style, and her charismatic smile had transformed her into Venus. Softness, childlike traits, and frankness of her utterance vanished from her demeanor. She was now a grave, humble, and peculiarly quiet girl. She began to study late night, inspired me too to do the same. Though she was on the stage amidst crowd, yet her concentration was only on me. Her dance at the fresher party exhibited two different personalities of Urvasi. The moment her eyes met mine, she smiled. I was standing quite away, watching her like a spectator. She skipped friends and reached to me. It caught few while summing up the whole program. "Sorry," said she, reaching to me. "Mention not, loved your dance," said I, smiling. "Let's go, I feel hungry." "Where?" I followed her. She was rushing down through the stairs. "Witty," she answered. She questioned, stepping down the stairs. "Don't you feel hungry?" "Yes, I do," I said. "Why didn't you tell me?" She wrote us to Witty. Her hairs brushed my face with the wind brisk hurriedly passing back. The best things I liked about her was her incredible intuition, the way she knew my unquote inmost. The scorpion grasses.